Hey, I have Tuffy Stone, and they call him the professor, okay? He got that nickname when he was a judge on, what was the name of the
barbecue
show?
Barbecue Pitmasters. John Marcus gave it to me.
So if anybody can teach us how to barbecue, it should be you, Tuffy.
You know, I'd like to think that I could at least help. So
so this is a what? This is what you're going to be doing. What kind of meat is
it? All right, so down here at Memphis May, we've got hog cookers, we've got rib cookers, and we've got whole pork shoulder cookers. So this here is a beautiful cut of, actually this is Smithfield Prime, but if you look at the meat, you can see the marbling in here, these striations of fat. And when we cook that to tender, it's going to make for a juicier tasting piece of meat.
So if I'm at home trying to figure out what the heck to put on my barbecue for the weekend, I look for what? Something not this big, probably. I'm kind of intimidated. But.
Sure. So when, whether it's you or anybody that's out there watching, you want to start with good meat. So if you look and you see just a little white marbling in here, go to your butcher case, go to your market, look through the cryovac and look for striations of fat. That's going to be flavor, it's going to be juice. This is the whole shoulder. So this top part, people are back home are probably going to cook more, and that's the pork butt. Then it gets into the picnic.
Okay, you're coming out with you've just come out with your first cookbook. It has been waited for. I mean, this one's been, people have been going, when are you going to do this? So if you want a lot of fat to have a successful barbecue, what about like fish? Is it hard? Because I know you have some recipes for fish in there. What's the hardest thing to barbecue?
Right. Well, probably the hardest thing to cook and barbecue is right down or right up the river here, and that's a whole hog. Because with a whole hog, you know, you got the shoulders, and then you've got the hams, and you've got the ribs and the loin. And so for those pit masters to cook all those pieces and parts to be the proper doneness is really a challenge. But I would say there's probably two or three keys to successful cooking whether we're here in Memphis in May or whether we're in our own backyard. And that's, I like to treat smoke like salt and pepper. I want you to, whether it's fish or ribs or chicken or pork shoulders or whatever it might be, I want you to taste that meat first, and then I want that smoke to be a backdrop flavor, and I want the rub and the sauce just to be a nice little pop. But you know, I think that's probably one of the things everybody struggles the very first time is we put too much smoke on whatever it is we're cooking. You see all the smoke coming out of the stack and you say, yeah, I'm smoking. But you really want a clean stack.
And you started actually in a French restaurant. It really seems sort of counterintuitive.
Yeah, you know, there's a couple of weird things about me in the world of barbecue. I'm one of the smaller barbecuers out there, and I'm one of the few that actually started off getting yelled at by a French guy.
So you should have been here the year France was the honored country. You could have yelled right back.
I could have brought my chef with me. He just lives right down the street for me.
All right, well, good luck. You have done well. You have judged competitions. Last but not least, what's the single most important thing when you're judging that you look for?
You know, I think whoever's going to win this weekend more than likely is going to hit perfect tenderness. Everybody talks about a rib that's falling off the bone, and they're great, but that just says that no one likes tough barbecue. When you cook it perfectly tender, it's silky, it's juicy, kind of melts in your mouth, but it's not mealy, it's not overcooked, so tenderness is the key.
All right, well, good luck to
Thank you,
Tuffy.
So much. Thank you.
I'm going to get your book because I might be able to figure out how to barbecue correctly if I get some cool smoke in my life. Back to you, y'all, from the Memphis MA International Barbecue Cooking Contest.